Students, today I'll start a second chapter by Magaminko. This chapter has been taken from the book Snapshots of your class 11th. Magaminko, pseudonym of Saramenko, born 31st March 1920, is a Dutch journalist and writer. Her real surname was Menko, but an official accidentally switched the first vowel. The story centers around a daughter who goes in search of her mother's belongings after the war in Holland. She finds all the objects which arouse memories of her earlier life. However, she decides to leave them all behind and resolves to move on. Mrs. S. Dotto visits Mrs. Darling's house after the Liberation War in Holland. She remembers the address, therefore reaches there and meets a woman, Mrs. Darling, whom she knows very well. To her surprise, Mrs. Darling, who was a frequent visitor to their home before the war, refuses to recognize her. The narrator introduces herself again and again, but all in vain. Mrs. Darling is wearing a green knotted cardigan which once used to be owned by Mrs. S., her mother. Narrator wants to talk to Mrs. Darling, but later turns a blind eye and shuts the door on her face. The narrator once again confirms the address by looking at the nameplate again, which suggests Mrs. Darling in black letters on white enamel and house number, that is 46. Having been dejected by Mrs. Darling, the narrator walks slowly to the station. While walking down, she recalls the moment spent with her mother and the time when things had started disappearing from her room and as well as home. When inquired, her mother told her about Mrs. Darling, who was an old acquaintance whom she had not seen for years. But suddenly she had turned up and renewed her contact with her mother. Narrator's mother also adds that every time she leaves there, she takes something home with her. According to her mother, Mrs. Darling had taken everything starting from antique plates to crockery used at their home. In short, she would insist to give all those things in order to save them from the war. According to her mother, she would carry a full suitcase or a bag stuffed with household things. Her mother wanted the narrator to remember the number 46 Marconi Street, that is the address of Mrs. Darling. The narrator once again decides to go to Mrs. Darling's home. This time, a girl of about 15 opens the door. The narrator inquires if her mother was at home. She denies, saying that she has been to market to run an errand. The narrator enters her house and sees an old-fashioned Hanukkah candle holder, wooden tablecloth, teapot, spoons, and many other things which once belonged to her mother. She even feels the burn mark which is still there on the tablecloth. Seeing the things placed in a distasteful manner and feeling that they have lost contact with her mother, she decides to leave the house. Soon she realizes that she has to catch her train. She leaves the house and decides never to come back again and to forget the address of Mrs. Darling's home.